This is San Aquil. Welcome back to Thedas. So, yeah, what does Mother Giselle want with our frame? I don't know. Welcome back, as I was saying. Let's, as usually, check that everything is working properly. So, obviously, as usual, maybe if you know, the title for the stream is obviously wrong. So I'm gonna see if I can actually, I did a thing today and it's obviously still showing that title. Also, for some reason, I made a mess. Okay, I do make messes. I do that. So let's wait for a second and see if we can actually set the title straight as everything loads up. So, how's everyone doing? I have to celebrate you, baby. No, that's not what I wanted to say. But I have to tell you that, unfortunately, I realized, no, okay, from my PC, the title of the stream is absolutely right. I don't know. Anyway, so let's see if it works from here. Like, I go to the channel. Well, I'll check this and while we see if anyone is around and actually wants to run around Thedas for a while. Okay, appears to be working. So yeah, I'm not gonna mess it up, but afterwards I know it's going to be wrong. Okay, right now it's exactly working, so let's check mic. Okay, I realized rewatching bits of last night, the last stream I actually did, I realized that station's cooling system, the fans, the only fans I got. But I'm sorry if it's noisy and it's a bit inconvenient. I will try and move the mic slightly away and see if it's any better, because I find it a bit inconvenient, but okay. Yes, it's the cooling system from the fans from PlayStation that unfortunately are really noisy, and I don't know why it's so worked up. Anyway, let's begin, because we have a long road and a long journey ahead of us. Okay, so this is tonight. I hope you can hear me. I hope it works even at a little distance. Is it working? I hope so. Let me know. So, as I was saying, we have a long road ahead, and this road leads to the Arbor Wilds. But first, we're gonna do something that I was almost... Oh, look at that. We have a gridlock. Okay. I was almost forgetting. And I was wondering, why didn't I get that particular war table operation yet? Because I did not speak to Morrigan yet. And I'm going to... Why is the elf Lorinil there? Okay, I don't want to know. We're going to speak with Morrigan, okay?
I understand you have spared the Grey Wardens from destroying what goodwill was left them. 'Tis good of you, considering the weakness Corypheus exploited was their own doing. Oh. Still, should a true archdemon one day arise, they will no doubt be needed. Or so they would have us believe. One thing which makes me curious, Did you encounter the hero of Ferelden at Adamant Fortress?
Okay, so we did not, but I always wondered. I mean, the hero... Oh, can you hear me, by the way? Hello, I see someone is up. I hope you can hear me fine, because I'm actually trying not to make the mic pick up too much noise from the PlayStation. I always wondered if the hero of Ferelden actually could have been at Adamant, or if really she or he are elsewhere, as they claim to be. We'll never know. Anyway, did we encounter? Absolutely not. You knew her, of course, we know.
Was the hero of Ferelden a friend of yours?
We traveled together during the time she fought the Blight. I helped her, and she helped me. Indeed, without her, my son would never have been born. Regardless,
yeah.
Did you see her?
It was very chaotic. That is true, but not that I know of, because I am sorry, I don't like that. It means, it looks a bit like, I'm sorry, I've seen her, she's dead. It's not like that. Anyway, my hero of Ferelden for this world state is an elf, and she's a Surana, so she's an elven mage. Not that I know of, Morrigan.
I met no one by that title.
When the Champion of Kirkwall mentioned a Grey Warden ally, I assumed it would be she. It was, after all, just the sort of thing in which she would involve herself.
It was,
but that rather
it?
Begs the question, if the hero of Ferelden was not at Adamant, where is she? My suggestion,
right.
Track her down. She could be a great aid against Corypheus, or a terrible foe to the Inquisition.
Whoa, 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 why would she be a foe? No. So, you know about, you know, elven lore, maybe?
You seem to know a great deal about elven lore.
The Dalish are not the
I'm
only ones
not
interested
sarcastic
in the distant past,
at
Inquisitor.
All.
Indeed, my skills allow me access to places the Dalish dare not even dream of.
Oh, come
the
on,
The ancient
please.
Elves hold secrets they have not yet given up. Secrets about the foundation of Thedas itself. Thus, they are my focus.
Look at Corypheus the height
clearly
difference.
Feels the same.
Yeah, Morrigan, less, if you can, please. I never noticed how skinny Morrigan is. Like, wow. I mean, didn't they feed you in the wilds? Anyway. Okay, goodbye. So,
I'll leave you to the garden.
Of course.
I find absolutely adorable the fact that... Ooh, I cannot speak with you anymore. The fact that Kieran is voiced... Okay, the voice actress for Morrigan is Claudia Black. And she looks a bit like Morrigan, actually. Even she has light hair, she has blonde hair, but the face has something. They clearly somehow put something of Claudia Black into Morrigan. And she has this fantastic voice that you just heard. And her son is called Odin. I mean, there's a kid. Okay, he's not a kid anymore, because it's been like, wow, 6 years. But there's a young boy out there called Odin Black. Okay? Just let that sink in. And he voiced Morrigan's son Kieran. So he has a good child voice, because he is actually dubbed, it's actually voiced by a child, which is very rare. But since he was Claudia Black's son, they probably got him to work with his mom pretty easily. So, we are here. We are here gathered, my dearly beloved, to go and try to kick Corypheus' arse. We're gonna try and see if we can do this in one night, and if not, probably gonna come back for a second part, okay? We're gonna see. I don't want to rush this because this is a pretty long part of the game. So we're going to see. Okay, let's first, as usual, check the war table. So we have, oh, Inquisitor Lavellan. These humble lips will always praise the Inquisition. You ask for nothing, but please accept this small token as my thanks. And you're very welcome, Sister Paulette. We saved her and a bunch of soldiers. Okay, then let's see what's what in Orlais. Okay, we just gathered resources. Nice. And, we managed to meddle in some politics. Madame Ambassador, I would be honored to accept your invitation. I shall make arrangements to pay the Inquisition a visit presently, as I have been most curious to see your organization for myself. Sincerely, Comte Renald de Mourier. Okay. I can hardly wait. So, as we can see, we are basically cleaning up the board. And that is good, but also a bit frightening because it means, yeah, we're getting there, right? Okay, this is what you're gonna do, but first, let's see. Ooh, operation. So, contact the hero of Ferelden, alright? But first, I want to see, because I've done this mistake once, so... Okay. What pride I've brought. The Inquisition is now for... Okay, we can do this. Yes, and we're gonna... Okay, we are a little low level, but now we can do it. I think we can do it. First, we're gonna do this. Okay, so while we are away, someone will contact the hero. And who's gonna be that? Sister Liliana, none of our agents have seen the hero of Ferelden, but our normal work led us to scattered references of her passing through the area. It will take a serious commitment of resources, but we could attempt to contact her. Sister Regan. So only Liliana can do this because she actually has the spies and she was actually a companion of the hero Ferelden. My hero romanced Alistair, so I guess Alistair could do that, but he's the king, he has other stuff to do, and also he's basically saying, yeah, I kinda know where she is and I'm not telling you. The others are not participating in this mission. 16 hours.
Inquisitor.
So yeah, it's a good thing that we do this while we are away. And now let's go. The Inquisition is now a force to be reckoned with. Call its allies to rally their soldiers and march with Inquisitor Lavellan's army to the Arbor Wilds, where they will face Corypheus's zealots one final time. The Inquisition must stop Corypheus before the Darkspun Magister finds a long-lost elven artifact in the wilds that allows him to enter the Fade physically and claim its power.
With an Illuvion, Corypheus could cross into the Fade in the flesh.
Indeed, the Inquisitor can attest that these artifacts still work, if one knows how to use them.
What happens when Corypheus enters the Fade?
Why, he will gain his heart's desire and take the power of a god. Or, and this is more likely, the lunatic will unleash forces that tear the world apart.
I like you when you're practical, Morrigan. So we can't have that.
In Redcliffe, I saw the future Corypheus built. We can't let that happen.
It was always so, was it not? The madman would bury us all.
Pardon me, but does this mean everything's lost unless we get to the Illuvian before him?
Kinda.
Corypheus has a head start, no matter how quickly our army moves.
We should gather our allies before we march.
Can we wait for them? We should send our spies ahead to the Arbor Wilds.
Without support from the soldiers, you'd lose half of them.
Then what should we do?
Hey, guys. I advise to stop panicking, maybe, perhaps. Yeah, exactly. Just another Monday in Thedas. Because Silver says it could go very bad or it could be way worse. Well, just another Monday in Thedas then, absolutely. So, you work as a team. I advise we stop panicking.
For starters, we don't let Corypheus worry us to death. Imagine how embarrassing that would be.
I mean, chill.
Josephine,
guys.
Have our allies send scouts to meet us in the wilds. Leliana, your fastest agents will join them. Together, we'll have enough spies to slow down Corypheus's army until Cullen's soldiers arrive.
Yes! I love this scene
Such
we're
confidence.
Getting now.
But the Arbor Wilds are not so kind to visitors. Old elven magic lingers in those woods.
Yeah,
we'd be
I'm
remiss
elven.
To not take advantage of your knowledge, Lady Morrigan. Please, lend us your expertise.
Ooh,
it's why we came here. Although it is good to see its value recognized.
Any further instructions, Inquisitor?
Yeah, guys, this is kind of it. So, I'm proud of all of you, kind of. This is going to hurt, or Corypheus has this coming. What's up? No, we're not going to do that because it's going to backfire. I'm proud of you.
The Inquisition began as a handful of soldiers. Thanks to you, we're now a force that will topple a self-proclaimed god. I could ask for no finer counsel, no better guidance.
I speak for all of us when I answer.
Aww.
We could ask for no finer cause.
We'll hound Corypheus in the wilds before he can find the temple or this Illuvion.
Illuvion. I love how she says that. And here we go. Guys, ready to go. I absolutely love the scene that we are getting now, so I'm not gonna speak on it, okay? The Inquisition is now a force to be reckoned with. Call its allies to rally us. Okay, we read this, so yeah. Let's go confirm operation. Okay, so, before we get the scene, we need to decide. Ooh, this is gonna be... this is always tough. Okay, so what we're going to face is mostly human, but Red Templars are going to be there. So we need to prepare for that. And I'm not going to go without Blackwall. Blackwall is basically my go-to guy in this playthrough, okay? I specced him right, I armed him right, he's going to come with us. I am also going to bring a rogue, but I'm going to be honest with you guys. I could experiment, not this time. I'm going to bring Varric. And since we're going to a temple that is the Elven Glore, with me is going to come the boyfriend. Absolutely. Because I cannot not bring Solas to the Arbor Wild. And if you played through this part, you absolutely know why, right? So let's go. Ready? Let's. Oh, what could possibly go wrong? Absolutely everything, right? Oh, I can't wait. Come on. Give me the cutscene. I want this. I savored this. Hello? Okay, as soon as I start to talk it... Precisely. I was grinning like an idiot. I love the big cinematic scenes of Inquisition.
Inquisitor.
How goes the battle, Captain?
The Red Templars fall beneath our blades, Your Worship.
Yes.
Commander Cullen says they're nearly finished. Our scouts saw Corypheus traveling towards an elven ruin to the north. We can clear you a path through his armies.
Okay, a couple of things. I love and hate how everyone is stabbing maps. Why? Oh, okay, note to self, next time I get the chance, I want to ask one of the bio people, the Dragon Age people, why all that map stabbing. And there is a piece of art, of concept art, which is one of the concept art that they did pretty early, that shows a group of people, clearly the Inquisitor and Cassandra and Liliana, and there is, I don't remember if it's Liliana or who is, that is violently stabbing the map, and there's Dorian in the background with his hands on his head, like he's screaming, no, what the fuck are you doing? Someone drew that map by hand. It's not like they're printed or anything. What the fuck are you doing? Stop stabbing the maps. They're priceless. Okay. Anyway, here we go. We can clear you a path through his armies. Yeah, boss, do you think maybe we should pursue Corypheus? You know what, Captain... care, okay?
Do only what you must. We need enough people for a celebration when we get back to Skyhold.
We will not fail you, my lady, no matter what comes. And Drastic,
yes,
guide,
stay alive.
Visitor.
Please, stay alive. Stay alive.
I wonder, is it Undraste your soldiers invoke during battle, or does a more immediate name come to their lips?
You know what? I have been listening. Look at how cute we are. I have been listening to party banter from Dragon Age Origins, like you listen to the radio or while I do chores in the house. Chores in the house? There's some chores in this house. Chores? Sorry. What was I saying? Okay. And Morrigan in Origins... we all love her because she is, you know, this super sassy, wise but young, and acidic and witty and whatever. But she's kind of a bitch. In the way that she is very uncalled for, especially with Liliana. Ouch. and with Wynn. Like, she's kind of, I don't want to say evil, she's just, I don't have the right adjective here. In Italian, I would say meschina. It's like petty sometimes, and just she wants you to hurt. And I get that it comes from a place of insecurity. No, she's not chaotic neutral. I am chaotic neutral. Sorry. I am a chaotic neutral. And that's not it, right? That's not even chaotic evil. It's just petty and bitchy in a way that is not, and I did not like listening to her as much as I liked playing with her. Okay, so I'm not the fucking maker, right?
They show me respect, Morrigan. No one mistakes me for the maker.
True. You are far more likely to come to their aid than a Chantry fable.
That is true.
If your scouts report accurately, I believe these ruins to be the temple of Mathal.
Which is?
A place of worship out of elven legend. If Corypheus seeks it, then the Illuvian he covets lies within.
Oh, also, they have gunpowder?
Let us hope we reach this temple before the entire forest is reduced to ash.
Okay, they shouldn't... Two things here. They shouldn't have gunpowder. Gunpowder is basically in the Dragon Age universe should be Gatlock, which is a technology exclusive to the Qunari. But, okay, Dwarven sappers know how to make things explode, so maybe. And two, and I know that if you know me and if you ever followed me, you know this is coming. You want to make me say Temple of Mithal, which is... Okay, this time I have not Mithal Vallaslin on my face as a Dalish, but I usually do, okay? I chose Dear Thamen this time, but usually I do have Mithal Vallaslin. I'm an elf. I'm a Dalish elf. And I know what the mother of my pantheon is and what a temple dedicated to her is. Alright? So, we're going to explore this camp because we're not getting another occasion. So we're going to speak with everyone who's here and it's speakable. And that means, look at that. We have a Imperial Majesty.
We are aware of the designs Corypheus has on our lives and people, Ambassador. You must excuse us, however, if our mind wanders to our beloved kingdom.
I pray our lay fares well in your absence.
It is our return to court that concerns us. Our dear cousin Gaspar warns it might align with poor weather.
Oh. It's ambitious to predict so far into the future. I'm confident your majesty can weather any storm.
We will see how this battle proceeds.
Now,
it threatens to engulf us.
Unfortunately, I botched in hushed whispers. And I thought I managed to get Briala Gaspar and Celine to work together as a trio, but I failed. And instead, I got Briala killed. And I'm very sorry about that. And now the two cutthroats here are working together. But, yeah. I kind of like Celine, and I blame Patrick Weeks for that.
We are gladdened to see you, Harold. This day will be recalled for ages. We are privileged to witness
Let's
the fulfillment
in a good way.
Of the Inquisition's purpose.
The honor is mine. No. The Inquisition... My soldiers need me. Bye. The Inquisition might persist.
There are other ills, Your Majesty, that the Inquisition may be called upon to attend. We will note them with great interest. Men and women of faith serve you. Their favor is no less than our own. Their service no less dear. With Orly at your side, we will see you victorious against Corypheus. May you walk in the light.
Yeah, kinda. Okay, let's see if Josie has some precious advice.
Inquisitor, I hear this Illuvian lies in a temple nearby.
Yes?
That's where the fighting will be worst. And Rassi keep you safe.
Yes? No shit, Sherlock. Come join us. Are you crazy? Keep yourself safe.
He's closer. You may count. Good luck.
Thank you, dear. Josie, my dear. Okay. This is Sparta in like 300. Okay. These are legions. Okay, look at this place. The Arbor Wilds map is one of my absolute favorite. And it's pretty linear, actually, but I managed to get lost anyway. So, yay! Come get lost with me. So, I usually try to explore where I can, but you cannot get around much without dying. Falling down here and you die, and then it's done. But I wanted to get... Okay. Oh! I'm an idiot. Sorry. I realize now that I have still... HUD visibility. Contextual. Thank you. Right. Okay. Yes. Because I actually had removed that. Okay. To take screenshots. And I kind of need it now, not to get lost too much. So we're going to pick up every material because we need to start crafting some decent armor next time, okay? What's in here? Is this? Ooh, lot of materials. Yeah, now you understand why we are probably not gonna make it in one session, right? So someone has leveled up while we were talking with the Empress. Okay. Who's leveled up? Varric and Blackwall. Let's... Okay, we're level 19. I thought we were way lower. Yay! So, Blackie is basically a god right now. I don't like the left side of the champion tree, ability tree. But we're going to get them sooner or later. Yes, no, yes. I cannot unlock this ability because I need to unlock this one first. Okay, and at this point I'm usually getting... passive abilities more than active because I'm pretty happy with the slots that are already in use. Okay, I want you Solas, and you know that. But I want you to have some nice ability like... Oh, you already have that. Okay, I'm going to see if we can... Oh, yes. Okay, you can use Veil Strike. Oh, you can have Twisting Veil. Yes, this is nice, and I'm going to take it as soon as I can. But I want Solas to carry at least one electrical ability because we have not any electrical power. And yes, that's kind of a good idea. So yeah, and he's never using the Wall of Vice thing because it's honestly just very showy, but... not super useful. Ooh,
if the soldiers aren't careful with their fires, they'll do Corypheus's work for him.
One last push and we can lick our wounds. I wonder if Corypheus will show.
Do you sense the magic crackling? Something more powerful than the Red Templars stirs.
Do you, Solas? Why were you looking in the camera like in the office? Okay, this is our trebuchet camp, because Cullen can probably...
We can't send people east.
We can't let the Red Templars break the supply lines.
Cullen cannot resist using trebuchets. I think is written in his character sheet, if it was a tabletop RPG. Like, he is sexually excited by trebuchets. Oh. This...
So must the faithful renew their love of the Maker. Your penance shall be a joy, serving him with a heart of love unbound. Your struggle shall be a gift, for it redeems you in his sight.
What a beautiful voice. No, I'm not gonna finish the verse. I usually do that with the Andrastian Inquisitor, but...
The Inquisition brought you this struggle. Without men like you, it would fall.
The fight is justly entered, Your Worship. I was a pilgrim at Haven. I saw the wreckage and how you emerged to lead us. If the Maker bids me serve you, it will be done.
I like this interaction more, obviously, with an Andrastian Inquisitor. But it's nice anyway. Yes, let's take the other one as well. There must be a place around here where I can... get potions, or are we just that screwed? Yeah, we're probably screwed because I used them, I think. Well, anyway, we're gonna make it. It's not a big deal. It's not gonna be a big deal. Okay, look at all this nice stuff lying around. Okay, stop. Oh, those are just potions, but this is a supply cache. And, oh no, we're good. Let's see the others. So, yeah, let's see. You're okay. You're okay. Meh, Solas, as usual, is problematic, but... We do not actually need to replenish our supply cache, so it would be a waste. And it's a pity because we're not coming back here ever, so yeah. Look at this place though. This is the most beautiful map. And I'm also doing something here that, sorry, you're gonna see a blue screen for a second. No, I didn't want to do this. Sorry. I wanted to save. Because I'm going to come back here and take screenshots of absolutely everything. So yeah, I need a save point in a nice place where no one is actually trying to kill me. I just need to remember to not to say override that save. Okay, look at this tunnel. It's actually the trunk of a gigantic tree, isn't that just fantastic? Okay, let's go kill some Templars. Ooh, mushroom, giant mushroom, look at that. I want to jump on the mushrooms. Ooh, I can actually jump on the mushroom, sorry, but I never actually did this. Ooh, I cannot anymore, but I oh, okay, Iviani, stop being a child and look at the birds. Okay, there's people dying. Oh, we have Morrigan with us, obviously. So we're gonna see her in action. Okay, this is just Red Templars. Yes. And these are our people. These are the freemen of the Dales. But the ones that are actually now on our side. Which is nice. Punch people with the fade, as usual. That's our favorite thing to do. Guys, seriously, If you, like me, are one of those players who always choose... Always choose... it's not Arcane Warrior. Arcane Warrior was the name of the specialty in Origins. Now is... who's using potions? Guys, no. Horror clothes, okay. Ooh, I needed to visit the... Okay, I did not. Anyway. Rift Mage is a revelation. Is so satisfying. Boom! Just for this, it's worth it. And it hurts. Who the fuck is using these potions? I mean, who's using the potions? None of us. So, why do we hear... I don't know. We will hold. I'm coming, guys. I don't see much of the struggle so far, but look at this place. Sometimes when they say, what place would you like to live on in Thedas? And this came up on the stream the other night as well, with Karen and Patrick Weeks. No one actually... Okay, the Arbor Wilds would be a bit extreme, but to visit for a holiday, right, guys? Look at this place. Look at this place. It's beautiful. It's beautiful, and now let's go kill some people. Okay. The Great Waterfall. And you're going to fall. Boom. Satisfaction. Satisfaction. We got the Templar down. Down, down. We need to be careful because there are going to be those Red Templars who use that freaking ability with the Shards of Lyrium. And it hurts. That was Solas. That thing here is Solas doing. That's my boyfriend doing that thing with the fade. Oh god, Solas do that thing with the fade. That sounds dirty. And it was intended to. Red Lyrium. Also, you can hear how epic the soundtrack gets in this bit. Ooh, that was just so hard. Ooh, we also had a dragonfly? Okay. Never seen dragonflies around. We need to see what's here. Sorry, but I don't want to leave anything behind. Okay, maybe this stole my heart. Oh no, we've taken that. Hello, Mr. Templar. Let's see, who do we attack first? The Templar up there, yes. I like to take my time doing this because it's actually fun. It's so much fun. I mean, you're in a new map and you're finally just a bit tougher than your enemies, but not too much. That is satisfying, but not totally unchallenging, and at the same time, you're not chugging potions. Okay, look at this place. And this place, it's so beautiful. I mean, look at that. Anyway, sorry. I get distracted by the scenery. Hello? Boom. Okay. going to move. And the more you move, the less they get you with archery. Even if
those
there's...
Gray Wardens. They must be the last of those enslaved at Adamant.
Poor bastards.
Yeah.
Corypheus has them dying by the dozen.
Yeah, and has ours killing them by the dozen, which is not nice. Ooh, a lot of Fade Touch materials, which are pretty rare, and they have those fantastic effects that make an armor special. New dragonflies all around. Okay, this way or that way? I think this way, right? Okay, the fact that the Inquisition main theme with a variant, because it's slightly different, is playing should be a clear sign that things are getting serious, right? Okay, who's fighting for us? We could have come through here. Yeah. Who's fighting for us? These are mages. Okay, these are dressed like idiots, but these are mages, Inquisition mages, against the usual Red Templars.
I fall! The Red Templars fall!
Yes, the Red Templars fall. I mean, have you seen who we are? Okay. We're a bunch of godlike people. Yes! Boom. I love this sound. Okay, let's get that one. And those instead are Liliana's scouts. Nice. And that is dead. That is dead Red Templar. A dead Templar.
Running, your worship.
Yay! Okay, this is going to be a present for Paul.
For Haven and the Divine.
Yay, and for, I don't know, whatever. So let's get... Oh, we walk in a lot of water, obviously. Okay, let's see up here. Oh! I suddenly freezed. That is never a good sign. If I remember correctly,
there, ahead.
Yes.
An entire camp of Red Templars.
Look sharp. They've got archers on the wall.
Yeah. Blackie... Did we just level up? No, okay. Let's take a peek. Ooh, yes. We could do something fun. Let's see. No, we cannot do that yet, unfortunately. We need to get closer. And we're going to... try and get these guys down. Yes, I can take them both. That sounded dirty. Okay. Look at Solas doing the same thing it just did. Uh-oh, we now have the Rain of Fire spell. Ooh, I'm going to move away now. And punch. Okay, this is not a Templar, as you can see. This is a Sentinel Shadow. Ooh, who are these guys? And why are attacking... our party, right? Is there anyone else? Okay, no, this is Templars. Yeah, this suspicious black cloud is another one. So let's see if we can... Oh, these are clearly elven. Okay. This guy is basically dead, so let's finish it. Okay.
These no. Elves are damn fast.
Yeah, these elves are damn fast. I mean, Blackie. Ooh, look at that. Okay, who are you attacking? Look at Morrigan go. She's fantastic when she fights. Do we want to make it rain fire? No, I mean, there's just three of them. That would be a waste. Oh, look at all the damage flowing. I love it.
Who were those elves? They didn't look Dalish.
It seems this Temple of Mithal is not deserted after all.
Perhaps these creatures are the reason few return from the Arbor Wilds.
Oh, let's read. Captain Lowen. I don't want grumbling in the lower ranks that our Lord Corypheus handpicked Grey Wardens to be part of his Honor Guard over his Templars. Our charge is not to understand his will, it is only to obey it. Besides, our Master still sorely lost all but a few dozen enslaved Grey Wardens to the Inquisition at Adamant. If your soldiers are smart, they'll keep quiet about it. Lieutenant Keldon, Sir Corypheus is actually picking, hand-picking Grey Wardens. Oh, finally some Bianca supply, some Bianca stuff. Upgrade. The war will upgrade. Look at how much stuff you need to pick up, Iveani. So, let's begin this. So, Corypheus is apparently... Ooh, yes. Look at this place. Handpicked a bunch of Grey Wardens to be his honor guard. I mean, he doesn't strike me like the kind of guy who wants like a honor guard purely for, you know, hey, we're gonna chug a bunch of potions for decorative reasons, right? There must be a reason why he actually needs the Grey Wardens now that the plan with the demon army and everything is gone. Okay. There's a reason, right? There must be one. Obviously, I know what reason he has. But I'm not gonna spoil it for anyone who's watching this and has not played the game. Though, at this point, if you manage to get here and be somehow interested in the Dragon Age world without actually getting spoiled, wow. I mean, wow. You're good. Teach me your ways. Which way do we go? We can go here, we can go there. Oh, let's get back and take the other road, okay? Because it's more spectacular. If I'm not wrong. Look at how much material, how many materials. Ooh, how many materials. Can we go up here or not? Let's see. Jump, Ivani, jump! Ooh, loot! Where is it? Okay. Gold, yes, okay. Do we go up here, or are we going back where we came from? I told you I can get lost here. Alfred. Let me show you how I get lost. We got turned around. Yes, turned around. Okay, we need to get the other way.
At your command, Harold.
Yeah, everything's fine, guys. I was just, you know, patrolling. I was checking that no one was, you know, coming from behind. I love that if you bring Dorian with you in this setting, he says, what is this plant? It's exaggeratingly big and red and overdramatic. If Devinter knew about this plant, everyone would be everywhere and everyone would have it in his gardens. Oh, there even was a statue pointing the way. Iviani in. We could have foreseen that. Another gigantic trunk. I miss having Dorian around when I don't. I mean, I would always bring Dorian, but it makes sense to bring Solas in this particular occasion. So we got strange elves. Okay, let's see who's there before we actually attack. Red Templars, and these are scouts. If I'm not wrong, I have friend fire turned off, so I'm not gonna hurt my guys. You wanted to get close? Yeah, that's not going to happen. That's one of the strange elves, yes? Okay, that's too much magic in the air to actually show you something. Yeah, one less to worry about. Okay, they're dead. I mean, we're a force of destruction. I love how at this point, as you can see, you okay, right? Because, yeah, look at that. We are steamrolling through the enemies, right? And then you'll see when we get to the Frostbacks or the Deep Roads. Both are. Ooh, my controller actually trembled, vibrated. This way or that way? Okay, that way there's light, but I want to see what's in here first. Both the Deep Roads and the what's here, and the Frostbacks are humbling experiences. I mean, yeah. Okay. Wrong way. I need to go there first, and then we get here. Okay. Okay. I'm coming. I will use this shortcut. Ooh, look at that! Okay, let's see. Mages? Rebel mages. This is Fiona! Oh, Fiona! Oh, girl. Okay. Our girl Fiona is fighting for the Inquisition with us. Nice. If you've seen the video that I actually uploaded today, you know why I... Oh, I got lost. What happened? Okay. Why I am this excited to fight alongside Fiona. And you know what? It's time to do this. Oh no, we can't. We're too far away. Oh no. Oh no. Let me rain fire on them.
We hold these monsters, Inquisitor. The Free Mages stop. the light!
Yes! Come on! Let's kick their arses! Fight? You get to meet all your friends and allies. I think we passed Liliana somewhere. Yeah, she's super pissed off because, you know. In the other... Okay, that was a good thing that we did. And in my head canon, he's Anders. And, the one in front of me. In my head canon, this is Anders. Because there is always here one of the rebel mages dressed like this and with this haircut. And obviously, it's just a cell sword. But... you know, cell sword, yeah, dressed like a mage, yeah, convenient. Like in Skyrim, they're called spell swords. I love it. So, okay, let's go. Oh, we need to get up here, down there. I don't know, I'm lost as usual. So I think we passed Liliana. Or maybe we're going to see her here, around here. Let's see what kind of... Okay, forces. Okay, this is one of the Sentinel Shadow. He's not looking good. He's not exactly super in shape. I mean, looks a bit dead. Everything is done here. We can actually get that Sentinel Shadow there. So we met Josephine, obviously, at the beginning with Celine. We met Fiona. And I think maybe we passed Liliana without speaking to her. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Silver. Yeah, there could be some issues, actually. Okay, let's see. Because connection was not super duper working today. Let's see. No, it's pixeling. Oh, it is pixeling like crazy. Let's see what we can do, right? Okay. Oh, that's Liliana. Look at that. Oh, there where Liliana is. Up there, that's Liliana. You can go say hi. Look at that. Look at Lily. Okay, I'm gonna check something right now. Say, this... It's been a while since it happened, actually. It usually happened when I streamed on YouTube. But, yeah, it was bound to happen on Twitch as well. Because it's more of a connection issue. And my connection is not... super duper good at all. Just an euphemism. And sometimes, yeah, it gets funny. Okay, let me just check the status and then we're going back to work, okay? Okay, this was my super cool keyboard noise. I love it. Let's see. What are you doing? Come on. Everything seems to be working. Everything seems to be working fine. Let's just do one other thing. Because, unfortunately, I have to use Wi-Fi. Because I cannot connect with Ethernet cable, so yeah. Okay, actually, the download speed is higher than the test that I did before. And the upload as well. It's better than when I tested before starting the live stream. But that's from a PC. That's from computer. So yeah, it's the PlayStation. Obviously, it's the PlayStation. Because I actually never have these kind of problems with the PC. Let's see how it goes. Inquisitor.
We are keeping them at bay. Follow the river to the temple.
Let's see how it goes. If it gets bad, I'm gonna try and... Oh, I missed. Sorry. And, stop the stream and start again. I'm on Twitch now and it's way easier to do. Also, it's been 1 hour. 1 hour since we started, and we're like, yeah, not where I wanted to be. We're not halfway through. I told you this part is. I'm gonna save for good measure, and I'm going to remember not to overwrite this one. But I'm going to overwrite an older, like this one. Okay, it unfroze for me. It's not super good. Okay. Let's go and kill these guys. Once you get there, you see that inside here we get some Red Templars, of course. Who are fighting another bunch of these sentinel shadows, and also there's a nice supply pack, which is always nice. Die! That hurt, right? Varric, do not run ahead and wait for the group, okay? You know, bad things happen when you run ahead. Ooh, that's a bad, bad situation up there. I can see it. So, I'm going to... What was that? Okay, I don't want to know. I am going to save, and we are going to just stop the stream and try reloading, okay? Okay, this is the last one. I need to overwrite this one and not the other one. Oh, by the way, we passed the 100 hours mark, have you noticed? Last time we did that, we were, as you can see in this third one, we passed the 100 hours. So when they tell you Dragon Age Inquisition, yeah, it takes approximately 100 hours to beat. That's if you basically not do everything that you can do, right? I guess if we took the other road, the one that I say no, this is not, we would have come out from here. Let me check. Yes. Okay. Yes, and this is a very, very knowing playthrough. But yeah, a lot of people say that Inquisition takes 100 hours approximately to beat. But that just means, I think, if you do just the strict necessary, And I said when I started this playthrough, I said that I was not going to do a completionist playthrough. Not even a challenge. But I cannot. Look at Liliana go. We gotta help her. But I cannot resist, you know, picking up some random fetch quests, or, as you can see, looting everything that moves, or that has stopped moving, to be more precise. Look at the sizes of these trees. I mean, okay. I'm gonna save again, because we fought, and so we need to save. So, guys, a little break, and then we're gonna come back and see if we can actually get a better connection, okay? I'm gonna try, at least. And if not, we're gonna try another night. But I knew it was gonna be, like, at least a two-parter. So, yeah. I was ready to pull, like, an all-nighter on this. No, not true. Not true, absolutely. So, let's do this. See you in, I think, 5 minutes. So, pee break. And whatever. Snack break. Okay. Okay. We're gonna try and see if it's better, right? Oh, from now it doesn't exactly look better. But I mean, the quality was never superb, but it works. Let's see. If not, we're going to try another night, but my hands are itching to kill some bastards. from my phone, it looks like it basically froze. So I'm gonna see. Because actually I did a connection test. I reset my extender and everything. And it looks like we are having the highest speed of connection I have had in the last, like, 2 weeks. There's another of those sentinel shadows, but it's... Okay, the quality is not superb, but it doesn't look pixelated to me. Let me know, Silver. Okay, we're gonna see, because I don't want to do that hard if it doesn't work, okay? There shouldn't be any issues, I mean. There shouldn't. Are you okay, Varric? You grunted like something was wrong. Cat and Weeks just liked my tweet. I replied to her tweet, and I like it. I love it. I want to be adopted by the Weeks family. I can walk little horse, baby horse. I can cook. I can also clean if you really need me to. Okay. Mostly I can take care of dogs and cats, humans occasionally. Okay, let's see, what do we have here? We should be getting pretty close, or are we going the wrong way? We are absolutely going the wrong way, as per usual. Dietro front. Okay, go back. Poor Inquisitor level. What the f- Okay, so if you go there, it counts as you take fall damage. I don't know why, but you do. So we're not gonna do that. And now we're probably... Okay, at least it doesn't actually count. It just makes you sound like it. Ooh, this guy is coming right at me. And he missed. Is dead. A lot of Thade touched stuff, and mind you, the name of my Inquisitor, Iviani, literally means Thade touched. So it gets blurry when there is too much fleshy stuff, but it should work. So we are back at this pavilion here. We lost. Let's see. We need to get up to the river here. So can we actually follow the river upstream, or as usual, I got lost? We go here. No, cannot. We're going to drown. Ooh, more enemies. Like, I guess every time I get into the wrong place, the game punishes me. Okay, maybe this way. Okay, we found. It was here. It was not that complicated. Okay, ooh, look at all these birds. And there's Cullen there, if I'm not wrong. And we are at the temple gates. I can hear fighting, but where are you guys? Yeah, right? I mean, you get into the wrong... You get the wrong road and you get hurt. Like, okay. I appreciate the strong encouragement, but talk about tough love. Look at that. There's Cullen fighting. We can leave him be. He's not in any danger whatsoever. So I'm not worried. Okay, let's get this guy. Okay, down.
Die!
Die so that we can have Collie Wally helping us. As you can see, he is perfectly fine. He shot for all the Cullen fans. Okay. That's nice. Are we done? Yes, you're all done. Where is it? It needs to tell stuff to me. Say stuff to me. Right? Not gonna say stuff to me? Okay, you usually do.
Alright, go on, Inquisitor. I'm behind you.
And here we are. Look at this place. We are at the temple gates. This temple was clearly gigantic. Part of it was overgrown by the forest. Let's get inside. going to get a scene, if I'm not wrong. Let's see, birds.
Look at this place.
This place is beautiful. I'm walking really slow because I don't want to overstress and see if it's better. Every time I move, it gets worse, right? I don't know why it does that. Anyway, we're going to get this. I'm going to save now. Let's see. Everyone is fine. How much? Oh, we basically are super duper fine. Look at that. And we didn't even use a single potion. Okay. Okay, guys. Supply cash that we do not need and some loot. Everyone's fine. Let's go.
There. That must be the Temple of Mithal.
I hear fighting ahead.
Yeah, we all can hear that, Morrigan. It's not like you're particularly, you know, sensitive. This is classical elven architecture with the arches. And here we go. And here, guys.
Namilana Sobanalin.
They still think to fight us, Master.
Meet Samson.
These are but remnants. They will not keep us from the Well of Sorrows.
Well of Sorrows?
Exactly. Well of what?
Be honored. Witness death at the hands of a new god.
Oopsie. So, not exactly as you planned, Corey Thieves. What are all those wardens doing there, I wonder? Hello, Samson, you do not look well. I have a confession to make. I still find Samson pretty hot. Don't tell anyone. Oops! Someone ate something that doesn't agree with them,
right? It cannot
right?
be.
Yeah, it kinda can.
Across
look at that.
Now.
So, Corypheus can, yes, get back from the dead using the bodies of Grey Wardens. Because the Wardens are tainted. Is sealed. Well, what can I tell you? So, there's this little problem where Corypheus can't die, apparently. Because, you know, he can die, but then he comes back through the taint.
in the body of wardens.
At last, Mathal's sanctum. Let us proceed before Corypheus interferes.
So, you want to explain why Corypheus said he was here for some Well of Sorrows and not an Illuvian?
I am uncertain of what he referred to.
Oh. So, you're not hiding stuff for me, you're just lost.
You're not certain? You said you knew what he was looking for.
Confidence can carry one only so far, it seems.
Uber.
I suspected. I did not know.
Okay.
Yes, I was wrong. Does that please you?
Yes, immensely.
Whatever the Well of Sorrows might be, Corypheus seeks it, and thus you must keep it from his grasp.
Absolutely. I'm frustrated, okay?
Let's find this well before Corypheus's people do. I want to know how Corypheus returned to life. We saw him die.
And his life force passes on to any blighted creature, darkspawn, or Grey Warden.
So that's how the bastard survived, Hawk.
For once, I'm relieved I'm not really a warden.
We'll find a way to stop him once we're done here.
'Tis strange. Archdemons possess the same ability, and still the Grey Wardens are able to slay them. Yet Corypheus, they locked away. Perhaps they knew he could do this, but not how.
That is all very insightful and basically true. If you remember, we found out that a certain Larius was a Grey Warden, or at least he said he was a Grey Warden, and he was a Grey Warden warrior first and mage afterwards. And he was the one who basically bargained with Bianca for the entrance to the Deep Roads and the indication to Bartran's Folly, where the Red Lyrium was. So yeah, he was basically carrying Corypheus inside him, and that's how he survived Hawk.
Yes.
So is Corypheus, stop hiding, truly immortal?
Are you certain Corypheus is using the power of the Blight to make himself immortal?
Perhaps you forget. I was in Ferelden during the Fifth Blight. I have seen a true Archdemon
rage. She
gets
all high and mighty.
How Corypheus gained the power to send his soul into blighted bodies, that is the real question.
Will answering help us?
Will answering that question let us destroy Corypheus for good?
Perhaps. I would suggest first dealing with the well. If Corypheus obtains it, any chance of success could be lost.
But we don't even know what the well is. Okay. Who are these temple elves? Any
You've
idea?
Seen the elves here. They seem odd.
Indeed. Two things are possible. One, this is a group of Dalish separated from their brethren.
No.
Cultists, fanatic in their desire to keep humans away.
No.
Two, these are elves descended from the ancients, having resided here since before the fall of Arlathan. The second appears unlikely, but if true, implications are astounding.
I'm going to casually turn around.
Is that even possible? How?
With magic.
To look at Solas?
Is possible. Whatever the truth, the Guardians successfully kept the temple a secret. They must kill all who enter, even the Dalish. A more sensible question might be, why?
Let's continue.
As you wish.
So, the other thing beside the fact that Corypheus can basically reincarnate every time you slay him, the other question is, what is this Well of Sorrow that he's talking about, right? Must be something that we did not anticipate. Related maybe to the Illuvian? Anyway. We are here, and this place is fantastic. And yes. wanted to see something, sorry. Okay. It looks good on my end. I hope it looks good on yours. So we have a lot of these statues of winged women. That you could see also, the wings are like dragon-like, and the head is strange and dragony as well. And if these are representations of Mythal, even we saw something like that, and this is the same thing, but with the wings closed, it looked like dragons. I think they are the evolution of a kind of sculpture that we've seen a lot in Origins around winged women. So now we get here. Alright. And as soon as you step in, look
at
that.
It appears the temple's magics are still strong.
Ancient Elven. I can't make out much.
Atishol via Abalasan. It means enter the path of the Well of Sorrows.
There is something about knowledge, respectful or pure. Shiven. Shivenen. Tis all I can translate. That it mentions the well is a good omen.
Oh, this, I hate the fact that we are Dalish and it's like we've never seen an elven thing ever. Anyway. And Solas, the fact that you can read that with no problem because you learned it in the Fade.
At least we know the Well of Sorrows was important.
Supplicants to Mythal would have first paid obeisance here. Following their path may aid entry.
So, good Andrastians. We offer a prayer to elven gods.
Yes.
If need be. Unless you wish to turn back.
Who's a Grudendrastian here? Okay. Not me, not Morrigan, not Solas. The only ones are you, Blackie, and Andrastian, okay, good, I don't know. And Varric. The only good Andrastian here is Varric. So, yeah. So, the goal here is to light up every one of these tiles without stepping on the same one more than once, right? So this first one is very easy, as you can see, no trouble at all. And it stays lit up. Is not going, and the door up there is not going to be this easy, unfortunately. Look at that, what's in here? Audible blessing and bodies, dead bodies. Okay.
I see the Red Templars have already encountered the temple's guardians.
Those elves lay an impressive ambush. Where are they?
Preparing another display of hospitality, no doubt.
So, be sure, if you come here, to get up here on the left side while you come up. Okay, and not on the right side. And if you go up here, take a stroll around. Also, we get this elven mosaic that are kind of pretty. And some loot. Yes, and not that. These are cairn. I think it's cairn. Anyway, rock. Artificial rock formations made to represent something. Who knows? And then we get into this little courtyard. Well, there is two things to note. These guys, these birds, all in circle. And as soon as we get in, they fly away. I always found that funny. And, ooh, look at that. A statue of the, basically the Dread Wolf, Fenharrow. Right? And he has a little box in front of him, as it often does. And the birds are back in circle. What the fuck is happening? And we have a statue of Fenharrow. Let's read. The Dalish use Arelan to mean traitor to one's skin, but the word does not appear in any elven text before the Tower's Age. The ancient root word is related to Harillan, or opposition, and Hlathan, or noble struggle. The Dalish call Fenharrow a god of deception, but I posit a far more accurate translation would be god of rebellion. What he rebelled against is a story lost to time. In Dalish legends, Fenharrow seals away the other deities out of love of trickery. If we understood more ancient Elven, we might find earlier versions of the Dread Wolf's story give him a more nuanced motivation beyond spite. And this is from a treaty on the pagan and heretical customs of the Elven by Senalin Tavernier of the University of Orlais, commissioned by Empress Selene. And this is mentioned in Masked Empire.
Why would this be here?
Something wrong.
You don't know.
It depicts the Dread Wolf, Fenharrow. In Elven tales, he tricks their gods into sealing themselves away in the beyond for all time. Setting Fenharrow in Mathald's greatest sanctum is as blasphemous as painting Andraste naked in the chantry.
Huh. My clan had Fenharrow statues.
My clan set statues of the Dread Wolf outside our camp.
Why
they meant
did
to frighten
she
harmful
turn?
Spirits.
Perhaps. I thought the ancient elves above quaint superstitions.
For all your knowledge, Lady Morrigan, you cannot resist giving legend the weight of history. The wise do not mistake one for the other.
Pray tell, what meaning does our elven expert sense lurking behind this?
None we can discern by staring at it.
Ooh. You'd make such a cute couple. No, I'm not gonna say that. Like, we can study this later. No, we'd make such a cute couple. I'm gonna say that. Who cares if he's going to be pissed at me, you know?
You two look like you're about to kiss when you argue.
It's time we pressed forward.
Agreed.
Ooh, you two have no sense of humor, and I am actually doing one of you, so yeah. So I promise I did not get my Inquisitor to turn around towards Solas after that. It did it all by itself. And yes, what are you doing, Solas? Actually, I want to know another thing that I want to ask the next time is what the fuck is with these birds in circle, like five birds? Like, you could basically draw a pentagram, right? Like that. What if I do that? Does something happen? Let's see. No, unfortunately, nothing happened. That's too bad. I always wish we could find some Easter egg that it's still not been, you know, claimed and found. But alas, the game is 6 years old and I think we found everything there was to find. So, look, guys, we need a point to divide this in actually in two, because this is not going to be a one shot. I cannot do this Temple of Mital thing all in one go. And since the connection is still not super super good, because it is actually, because I have enough speed in upload. Yeah, people are still finding stuff in Doom and stuff, so you never know. Yeah, you're actually right, Silver. But I don't know. I think we may have
the Temple of Mithal, constructed in an age when elves, not men, dominated this land.
Yeah, I
believed Mithal a goddess of justice. Elves came here to request judgment after they proved their worth.
Silence has reigned here for time beyond memory.
Ooh, look at this bird, how pretty. It's it's a big, big cockatoo, like really big. And I know, I told you you're big, I'm sorry. So I think we got everything that we could. I remember someone asking actually if there was still some Easter egg that no one had found, and I don't remember if it was at the time Mike Laidlaw maybe, or the usual trickster Patrick Weeks, or I don't remember. But they kind of said not that I know of, and they joked about stairs and the fact that there are a lot of stairs in Skyhold and something like that. But I'm afraid everything has been found, but I want to believe that there is some dev, some designer that put something that no one has stopped walking Blackwall. No one has yet found and is, you know, trying desperately to hint at it without revealing it, because some code between the devs is telling them that you cannot reveal, like give up. Like say, okay guys, I give up, you didn't find it. There's this thing here. Ooh, look at this. I'm going to do something. No, Blackie. Wow. Blackwall, he is really hot. I'm sorry. I know it's not very PC, but Blackwall is hot. Also, he was not in the way before. I wanted to do a nice couple picture with me and Solas. But yeah, not gonna happen. So guys, I'm gonna save now. Yes, this is the one. This is the way. And yes, after all, we did like the first stream, the one that we interrupted was actually 1 hour, and this is 48 minutes. So yeah, it's not that far to 2 hours, and that's, I don't want to go beyond 2 hours. And of course I'm saying this, and maybe next time when we actually get to the inner temple part, we're gonna to go do a 3 hour stream or whatever. But I'm going to stop here for tonight, and next time we're going in through that door, and we're gonna see what's in there. We'll have to do some of those floor puzzles, which I am so bad at. Okay, I actually feel every time I say, oh, I'm good at this, it takes is some spatial intelligence, and I'm good at that. You, I always nail logic quizzes. No, I don't. I'm so bad at that stuff. Okay, and I go in very confident and I end up frustrated. So I'm gonna go and take a look at those, probably, if I remember to, next time, so that I don't have to do them like 50 times in front of you. And also, I hope my connection is going to behave. If not, I don't know. So, these two parts are going to stay here for a while, and then I'm going to put them on YouTube. If you want to follow me here and there, I would be very, very glad. Also, I love this soundtrack. I didn't see it, but this is one of my favorite, and it's usually sound plays in the Storm Coast and here. And I wonder if any one of you is watching this without having played the game. This stream and the others, I mean, you did get the hints, right? It's not a surprise. And if you, even if you managed to get this far into Dragon Age without spoilers, is it possible that you don't get the hint? I don't know. Anyway, thank you for watching. Yes, she's looking at the wall so that I can do this without the face of my Inquisitor in front. And thank you for watching. See you next time. In the meantime, if you want... Oh, Solas is trying to walk through the door. Yeah, he does that. I hope you enjoyed this, even with the connectivity problems. Look at this place. This is fantastic. It's probably my favorite map in the game. And so I'm gonna show you if... Oh no, we cannot, because the Arbor Wilds are placed on their own, and as you can see, we do not have the option to go anywhere from here. We need to journey deeper into the temple, and we cannot go back. We're in front of the road and the ride. So, see you next time. Thank you for watching. And Mithal be with you.